concept neuromuscular coordination and flexibility of the joints and muscles of the pelvis and the lower legs. Technique is Yogendra Utkatasana. Let us condition ourselves. Please be seated in a comfortable pose of your choice. Please close your eyes. Abracadabra. For the next 10 minutes, imagine yourselves to be young, sedentary, high-flying executives of MNC taking part in a special executive camp at the Yoga Institute. You lead a pretty inactive lifestyle physically. The only exercise you perform is exercising your fingers, working furiously on the laptops, mobiles and the remotes. Your inactive lifestyle has not yet resulted in any health complications. Please open your eyes. Good morning. Hope you are having a wonderful experience at the yoga camp.
Yes.
I have some quick questions for you and I expect rapid fire answers to the same by voice vote. Yes or no? Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you feeling great today?
Yes.
Do you like to sit? Often?
Yes.
How often do you sit? Yes, you spend most of the time sitting in your AC room, your AC car, AC cabin and so on. Right? Once in a while you move your, stretch your hands or look around. But what about the lower half of the body, the bottom line? It tends to be totally ignored. You do not walk or move around. Right? Today we will learn about an asana which will take care of this. Today we'll learn how to stand and sit. Today we'll learn Yogendra Utkatasana. So Utkatasana is derived from two words. Ut, that is raised, and kati means waist. Utkat also means powerful or fierce. This asana is also referred to as the chair pose. It was devised by our founder Sri Yogendra Ji from the traditional rigorous exercise Danda Baitak, normally practiced by wrestlers, to strengthen the muscles of their limbs. Let us welcome my friend to demonstrate this asana. Before that, we'll go through the limitations of this asana. Acute deep vein thrombosis, please see. Acute deep vein thrombosis, sprained ankle, and mild osteoarthritis of the knees, plantar fasciitis, and those with cardiac problems should not retain or suspend the breath. Those with mild osteoarthritis, cardiac problems, hypertension may attempt with this wall support and with feet flat on the ground, that is without raising the toes. Prolapse, uterus, acute piles, and stiff joints and vertigo, and women in the first two trimesters of pregnancy. In the third trimester of pregnancy, they can attempt this asana if there is no bleeding or spotting. Okay, now for the demonstration. Please stand erect with hands by your respective sides. Neck straight, chin drawing, chest thrown forward and abdomen in normal contour. Focus the eyes at a point straight ahead. Inhaling in 3 seconds, stretch your hands forward, parallel to each other and parallel to the ground, palms facing downwards. Simultaneously, rise up on your heels, toes, and stand on your tiptoes. Immediately exhaling in 3 seconds, go down smoothly and assume a squatting position. Keep your knees parallel to each other and hands parallel to the ground. Stay in this position for 6 seconds, suspending the breath. Inhaling 3 seconds, come up smoothly, balancing on the tiptoes. Immediately exhaling in 3 seconds, lower your heels and your hands to your sides. Now let us perform this. You can perform maximum, start with 4 rounds with a pause in between the rounds. So please stand erect. your hands by your sides, feet parallel to each other with 1 foot distance between them. Neck straight, chin drawn in, chest thrown out, abdomen in normal contour. Inhaling in 3 seconds, stretch your hands in front of you, palms facing downward, hands parallel to each other and parallel to the ground. Immediately exhaling in 3 seconds, come down and your thighs resting on the calves, knees parallel to each other and hands parallel to the ground. Stay in this pose for 6 seconds, suspending the breath. Exhaling in 3 seconds, inhaling in 3 seconds, come up, rising on your toes. Exhaling in 3 seconds, come down. This is the pose. We can do this for 4 rounds with a pause in between the rounds. So benefits, what are the benefits of this asana? Thank you. There are numerous benefits. You can please sit down. There are numerous benefits which are derived from this asana. First benefit is flexibility of the joints, muscles of the lower limbs and pelvis. Then acute plantar fasciitis. The problem move is plantar fasciitis, or you won't have, because this exercise is the plantar fascia tissue which runs from the heel bone to the toe. And it's in the case of mild osteoarthritis, it releases mild osteoarthritis and strengthens the associated muscles. It strengthens and tones the calves, thighs, knees, chin and all the muscles. It helps in coordination and concentration of the entire, all parts of the body. Use a good overall contour to the body, since you're balancing your entire body weight on the toes. And then in the men in the third trimester of pregnancy, if it is practiced, it helps in normal delivery. So this is one of my favorite asanas. It helps me get going after being seated in a seated position for a long time. The key element in this asana is to go down gradually and come up as smoothly as possible. We should resist the temptation to go down quickly and come up very quickly. So as you practice the asana more and more, you gain control over the muscles and you can go down and come up. Any questions, if you can have, you can take.
How raising of wrist take place in this asana? Because here we are sitting and we are relaxed. How raising will take place in this asana?
Yeah, because here you are consciously engaging your core muscles. Basically, if you see, when you go up and come down, you are keeping your back straight. It's not, when you come up, it's not this way. So you are engaging this core, your waist is in fact held up, upright. And that's the reason.
This so, relaxation or raising?
Pardon? You are not relaxing, you are engaging the waist and hence you are strengthening and toning the muscles. And this, when done with the raised toes, obviously it goes, your entire body coordination, it helps. Yes? Any more questions? Yeah. No, no, it's, you can stand, as I said, in the third feet trimester of pregnancy. Obviously, doctor's advice is the best thing, and if it's advice, but in the third trimester of pregnancy, you can do it. And if comfort is the main criteria, so you may stand with the wall support and with feet flat on the ground, and then you can. Okay, so keep practicing, and hope this will motivate you to do this asana, and till we meet next time. Keep practicing the asana and share your experiences. Thank you.